And I have questions about how we can keep customers loyal to our product. Like, we have sold product to customer once, and how we can maintain it that customer will buy our product more. Yes.
Okay. All right. So if I understand correctly, then you say that how do we acquire loyal customers? This is what you mean? John, am I right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, I think Ngang is asking about how she can continue the loyal relationship with customers, so customer keep buying her for a long period of time.
Okay. So again, partial answer to your question was in the last question of Tien. You know, building trust and relationship. Okay. So, and there I was trying to tell Tien also, and you are also listening, that see, it's a long process and it has to be done day in, day out. You have to maintain that relationship, you know. So first and foremost thing is that when, if you want to retain that account, so you have to focus, you know, if you have acquired one account and your goal is to retain that account and sell more products to the account, then your existing degree of satisfaction of the client becomes of the most important. So how satisfied is the client with your services which he or she has availed from you? So you have to gauge that. Okay, so suppose client has used your services or using your services, and you want to make sure that client keeps on using that services, renews your license or buys new product from you, something like that. Then in that scenario, you have to immediately get into the hat of customer success manager. Okay. You are primarily a B2B sales, but as I told you that there are three trades: demand generation, acquisition, and customer success or after sales. So then in this scenario, your trades related to customer success should come more into play. Okay. If you are going to sell into a new account, your acquisition and demand generation trades should be on the plate, on the table. But here, once you have acquired an account and you want to retain, resell, upsell, renew, then your customer success traits should be in the play. So that is first and foremost. You have to have a very, very strong, you know, relationship with the client first. Second, you have to keep studying the need of the client, because needs are dynamic in any organization. Please understand. So if you understand that organization well or that client well, what they do, what their current needs, what their future needs are. So you have to continuously assess. The assessment of client needs is a continuous process. Even if you have entered into an agreement and sold your product, but you have to continuously assess, because needs are very, very dynamic. And in today's scenario, the needs keep changing or needs keep adding. So you have to be very, very vigilant. So when you can do this, when you have got a good relationship with the client or the person, you know, whom you are interacting. So you need to keep discussing that. How is their business? What are their plans? What are their expansion plans? Okay. New, if you are into training, okay, what is their new employee onboarding plan? How many, what is their budget for next year for new employee onboarding or hiring, you know? So accordingly, you have to continuously keep assessing their needs and also enriching your, you know, strengthening your bond, current bond with that client, you know. So then I think you will be able to very well gauge that if their needs are changing. Suppose you are offering, just to quickly example that, okay, you are offering some course in maybe CRM, maybe Oracle CRM, okay. So you client has bought your product and you are training the staff of the client, okay. You are doing training on Oracle CRM. For example, in the background, there is a decision by the company that the next financial year, they are shunting Oracle and they are bringing in some other vendor, you know, some other platform. So your Oracle training module need will be over. So that's how you need to continue. So you are ready with your new product that, okay, if you are migrating on SAP, here is our SAP training module for you. Let's talk about it so that when you migrate, we are ready to, you know, proactively train your staff. Or we can start training your staff even before SAP is implemented 3 months before. So you sell an additional product also, you know. So these kind of scenarios, this was just a very, very broad example to make you understand that. John, you would like to add anything here?
Thank you, Rajnish. Basically, these are pretty much well covered. Like I said, to build a loyal customer base is about keep giving values to the customer and keep giving values as many as possible. Even you would keep selling the product. Deal is closed means the relationship not over. It just moved to a new level of relationships. So keep giving that values to the customer will really get them comfort to keep working with you. And the second thing Rajnish just also mentioned about, also keep a little bit of eye, what are the particular tactical change they're going to make into their strategy. And if you just look into their tactical strategy end of the year, that means what they're going to do next year, you by looking into this one, you will see a lot more opportunity to do a lot of cross-sell about this project too. And when you come to your client, when you already sell and say, hey, you're doing that one and I can help you with this. I can help you with this one and I have a product for this one. And the client kind of really like it, that because that means they see that you kind of follow them and you are proactively always them and want to support them. What does it sound? It's like you kind of in a relationship with them, right? Who supports you, who follow you, who loves you, who in a relationship with you.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it works on in a B2B sales too. When you come up and say, hey, I know that this is the problem you're facing. This is the new strategy you're building for the next year. And I will help you out. I have a product for this one. And I think and then we can work together to take this mission forward. And that is the formula of building a loyal relationship over a customer. Now, is that clear? Clarify your questions?
Yes, thank you, Anthony.
Thank you.